Hey everybody, this is Buzz McKim, broadcasting from the Daytona Flea and Farmers Market for the Shop Now Network, and we're here at the monthly car show, the first Friday of every month, and they have hundreds of cars here. It's one of the best kept secrets in Daytona, and it's all free. Come on out, bring your grocery getter if you think it's a cool car, and stick it in the show. Won't cost you a dime. And look what we found here. We found a John Greenwood Corvette, and our good friend Russ is the owner of this beauty. How you doing, Russ? Yeah, real pleasure. What a magnificent machine here. Can you tell us the story of it?
Well, I was doing a little club racing in the early 70s with my Corvette, and then I modified it and ruined it enough where I couldn't drive it on the street anymore.
Okay.
So we followed the Greenwood history and story and that. So he's not too far from my house in Toledo.
Right.
We drove up there and bought one of his race bodies.
Yeah.
And 44, 45 years later, I'm finally getting around to putting it together.
Very good. Well, it is gorgeous. What kind of engine would you have there?
That's a big block Chevy,
yep.
555.
Oh, my.
The 420, don't pay any attention to the 427.
That's just for historical purposes.
Yes, historical purposes.
Right,
yes.
Right. I know what you mean. Wow. That is magnificent. Well, one of the members of our crew is the Corvette aficionado. In fact, we had him on the show last week. And when he hears about this, and I remember seeing a picture of this, I think on Facebook, and I told him about the car, and he started to salivate. And so I'm going to get some pictures, and I'm going to give him a hard time Friday when he comes to the show. And yeah, we have a racing show every Friday from the North Turn Restaurant.
Okay.
And we have all kinds of folks from different forms of racing. We've even had go-kart champions on there. We've had Andretti and Foyt, Richard Petty and Ernie Irvin and all kinds of folks like that there. It might not be a bad idea to have you on one day if you care to come on board and talk about your car.
That wouldn't be bad.
I think that would be awesome. And is this a dream come true?
Yes. Yes. My end goal or bucket list is to take and replicate Greenwood's car.
Yeah.
To honor him.
Yes.
And to take the Sebring 75 car and run it at Sebring.
Wow, that's
in
awesome.
In a track day.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be fantastic. Now, will you run Daytona with this car too?
I don't know if... The high banks are a little scary.
Yeah.
And something like that, I might have to do a little more modifications.
Yeah, I see what you mean. But then Sebring kind of tends to get a little bumpy sometimes. So it's
got good suspension.
Yeah, okay, and that's good. Glad to hear that. And the car is just perfect. And who did most of the work on it?
I did.
Did you really?
I did the frame and the roll cage,
uh-huh.
All the fabrication on the this and the that.
Yeah.
And the paint.
Yeah. Really?
And,
that's magnificent.
I tried to keep, through the historical documents I have, the exterior of the body is almost letter perfect,
mm-hmm.
to what he ran in 75.
Yes. Yeah, I've got some pictures of the car back in the day, and it is dead on.
And I talked to Bert on the internet,
mm-hmm.
and the only thing that he said that he did not want was to have the car portrayed as a Greenwood customer car.
I see.
He said I was more than happy to allow me to say it's an original Greenwood body.
Oh, beautiful. Okay.
And I respect him, and hopefully one day I'll get over to Apopka and let him see this car.
Wow, wouldn't that be awesome? That would be fantastic. I bet he'd be salivating too, I'm sure. What was the biggest headache with this car?
Getting the engine back in the historic location as far as moving it back and moving it over to the right. It's almost a 50-50 weight transfer. All the spring packages are 500 on front and rear. I mean, it really handles well.
Oh boy. Yeah, what kind of frame do you have under it?
It's a aftermarket replica of the stock frame that he ran.
Really?
With modern suspension on it.
Yeah.
And then I built the roll cage for it.
Wow, that's amazing. Well, you definitely have the touch of the maestro, that's for sure. It is absolutely fantastic. Can we take a look at the interior? Oh my. And I see you have a passenger seat if you have anybody brave enough to get in there and take a cruise with you, right?
Well, when I go to the track day as a rookie, mm-hmm. down here,
right?
They keep telling me that they have to have a guy go ride around with me and to see if I'm capable.
Yeah.
And hopefully this thing will work out well.
Wow. Did Greenwood ever take this to Le Mans?
Yes, he did.
Okay.
He took it there and through all the stuff that I've found, he ran. He didn't finish, but he was a big hit there. He ran 225, I think, on the Mulsanne.
Oh, my gosh.
And the people at Le Mans loved the car.
I'll bet they did. The steering wheel looks like it's off-center a little bit, off a little bit to the right, or is that just an optical illusion?
It's a removable steering wheel to help the old heavyset guy get out of the car.
I see. Okay, yeah. Oh, I got you. Okay, never mind. All right. Yeah, because there's a steering shaft right there.
Yes.
Duh, it's been a tough morning.
Well, you see a lot of cars.
Yes, we certainly do. But this has been magnificent. And I looked at this and I went, oh my gosh, we've got to talk to that fella. And we thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
It's been amazing.
Thank you,
Russ. Alrighty, Buzz McKim, Daytona Flea and Farmers Market with the John Greenwood replica Corvette. And we can call it a replica, right?
Yes, I appreciate it if you would.
Sure. Alrighty, and we will definitely get the word out. And we have a fella on our staff who is going to go crazy when he finds out that this car exists. So we're on to the next project here, okay?